Hey guys, welcome to round two of this Innistrad draft. I would like to play first. So this is actually, it's not a bad hand, a little expensive, but I have some one drops and two drops I can play, so let's go with that. Boom. Let's do it. So obviously Doom Traveler, I'm gonna go with that, then Walking Corpse. So Trepanation Blade sort of made up for itself that last round. Really, that Geist Catcher became like a 10 for 1. Just kept. Whoa. Don't want to make that mistake again. Apparently, I can't do two things at once, talking and playing, or walking and chewing gum, or really doing anything, or playing magic with one hand. Kidding. Anyways, the Trepanation Blade really paid off in the second game. That was pretty good, so I'm happy I have it. I have enough evasive creatures and a decent amount of tough guys that can really use that blade to its advantage. So hopefully that goes on. Okay, so this guy's playing zombies. Wow, okay. No lands, that's fine. Don't need lands. Lands are for losers. Snapcaster, no. Alright, we'll play the Interloper. So this is my aggressive beatdown deck, I guess. Wow, did this guy not have anything he can play? Really? No, he's got land. Okay. He's just messing with me. Armored Scab, that's what I'm calling right now. Cultist. Where were the Scabs this draft? Scabs are amazing, I love them so much. Okay, so I can't really attack with much. At least I got lands. I'll probably... Should I run in with the Doom Traveler? Nah. I'll use him for blocks. Let the Vampire Interloper do its work. I'm a big fan of this guy. I know he's just the worst Pegasus thing or whatever from M2. Ah. Claustrophobia. But he's good in black. He's very aggressive. Alright, that seems to shut down my offensive. Land. Perfect. Offensive not shut down anymore. So I feel like white instants to kill the kill spirits enchantments might be coming in this draft because wow, okay, fine, kill my guy, I don't care. Oh, he got rid of my Trepanation Blade. That's really unfortunate for me. I wonder, I could deadweight this guy. I don't think I will. I mean, I don't really care that much for this little dork that's blocking right now. I'm just going to run in with the Doom Traveler. Block it or not. Yeah, he's going to block it. Fine. Sure. So I'm going to get my guy. He's going to mill me. He's going to mill Swamp. I don't care. And I'm going to drop my Mausoleum Guard. I should have attacked with the Traveler earlier. I don't know what I was thinking. Because at this point I do want to race with him. I did not need to keep him back to block. Let's see what horrible things he's bringing in today. A Rotting Fen Snake. Awesome. And a Diagraph Ghoul. So this guy is going for blocks. That's pretty obvious. I'm going to just attack here for one. I think I'll hold on to my dead weight. Do I really care about a 2-2 right now, a 2-2 dork? I think not. I mean, I can... The other thing I don't want to do is kill his guys too early, because he might have some sort of... Zombie to Okay, so yeah, we're definitely killing his guys now. Not a problem. But yeah, we're definitely killing his zombies. So he's, so smite. Yeah, that's happening for sure. And I'm gonna deadweight this other guy. I don't want him going off with zombies here. Or not. I'm gonna run. If he kills my guy, so be it. If he takes damage, awesome. Yep, he's gonna block. I'm gonna get my two flyers. He's gonna mill another card for me. I milled a bonds, eh? Too bad. Milled some removal. Oh, he milled my other interloper. So sad. So it's rounded down. So he's not gonna get zombie token just yet. Good. Gonna think twice. The Going to think a second time twice. I believe he is. No, he's not. He's dropping a vampire. I ain't afraid of that. My pure bloods. Awesome. My pure bloods can take care of that. But I swoop in for three damage in the skies. No spirits, eh? Interesting. So he's really going zombie themed. And my second set of purebloods comes down. Poor endless rank. So yeah, but my enchantment removal is very likely coming in. I don't want endless ranks to just randomly destroy me. So what I could do is start swinging in with one of these purebloods. I probably could have done that last turn. Twice. So he's on a three turn clock. No, there's not much of a reason for me to attack. Alright, and he passes the game. So, Urgent Exorcism. Both of these guys are, I believe, are coming in. And what's going out? What is just garbage? Maybe this? Let me think. Probably not a lot of vampires. I mean, there's that cultist. I take one of these out for sure. And I do still have a Silver Chase Fox. Kills enchantments. So I could either drop that or drop my second Victim of Night. Oh, that's tough. I just don't want to be blown out by that card. Yeah, let's drop the second Victim of Night. I can bring it back in if I want. Good, this is a good hand. I'm definitely keeping this hand. No mull. No mull, and I will remember to drop my turn one drop instead of passing the turn like a complete idiot. Boom. Got my typhoid rats down. What does he think about that? Nothing apparently. Thinks nothing of it. Rats are going in. They're gonna go all the way. 20 damage from the poisonous rats. Cultist comes back down, of course. I'm happy to actually run in with my rats, personally. He can block it if he wants. He's not going to. His deck isn't very fast. Let's go with that. So, Chapel Geist went down. Let's erase him. I think I can get there. Okay. So something's getting blazing torched. And FYI, that something is the fence snake. Sorry, bro. Your snake's dead. He's gonna mail me. What is he mailing me? Oh, smite. Oh, I could have killed him next turn. I will. And then I can drop either Pure Bloods or Abbey Griffin next turn, depending on how I feel. And sell off. Selloffications.com. So he's thinking twice. Will he think twice again? Oh, he's putting curiosity on that? No. Oh, I don't like where this is going. Do I urgent exorcism it? Kinda want to. Oh, that's bad. Yeah, let's kill it. I don't want him blowing me out with curiosity here. May have been a bit unnecessary, but he doesn't have a lot of zombies right now. I think I'd rather not let him have that extra card. I don't want to keep the beats going, so Abbey Griffin it is. We got the beats. We got the beats. He's got a weird sort of Sell-Off Occultist beatdown deck. It's really strange. What does he have in his hand? A lot of six drops? Does he have a third color? What? Why does he have five cards in hand? It's really strange. I'm gonna take that. No probs. Manor Skeleton. Okay. Not really going to do anything about that. Just going to put on the beats. Probably could have attacked with the Typhoid Rats now that I think about it. He likely would not have blocked. So I'm going to put the Mausoleum Guard down because his job really would be the same as the Purebreds, which is the block, but then I get to block and get more attackers for next turn. So a more aggressive move. And putting down the pure bloods. I keep thinking of purebreds. Pure bloods. Alright, and that's the end of that game. Excellent. Let's move on to round 3, guys.